car that I want to show you guys is the A3 Cabriolet. Just off the back, just by looking at it, it is a little bit smaller than the A3. Where's the other A3?
By the way? I sold it before buying the...
Oh, right, correct. So Raul had the regular A3 as well, black one. We could have actually done a comparison, but he just got rid of that before buying the 220D. So this is what the A3 looks like, with the soft top convertible. And it's a lot smaller than the regular A3. Also, this one is a petrol, right? So 1.8 liter petrol engine. So this one, in fact, is not a Bangalore registered car anyways. Like I said, this one is for sale. I'll put more details in the description. You guys can get in touch with me if anyone's interested. We can discuss this. I'll put you in touch with Rahul as well if things get a little more on the serious side for it. But yeah, just a few minor things that need to be done, like a touch-up here on the bumper. You basically get what you see. The car is in good condition, hardly been driven. I think it's done about 25,000 kilometers. It's a 2015 model, right? This is a 2015, and I'll put all the details in the description for you. Let's see the car for now.
Should have turned back hours ago. Out of our minds, I guess we're sleeping outside. You're still a good time, even in the cold. Get out the road, I told you.
And of course, pillarless doors again on this car, considering it's a convertible. Just love the look of it when it's open. Okay, a quick look at the interior. It's pretty much the same as the regular A3 that you get. But do you find any changes in? Because you own both,
same,
so
there's a couple of features that the other one didn't have.
Yeah, for
like
the roof,
auto hold,
obviously.
The roof.
Okay. Oh, okay. This has auto hold.
Yeah,
as well.
That's about it. No other difference.
But the size of the screen,
everything,
the display,
the same.
Everything the same. You can see the difference that 5-6 years brings to a car manufacturer. So, a much smaller screen in this compared to the BMW, of course. The display a little bit on the dull side compared to the BMW again, because that's all digital and screens. And so you can actually see what a couple of years, 5 years does to technology and the kind of features that we get in our cars. Not saying that this is outdated, but you can see the difference. I mean, I would still drive this car and not miss out on any features, because I'm sure it's still fully packed. Audi always somehow make sure that they have enough features in all their cars and all their generations. So let's take this car out for a short drive and we'll see how it does. Okay, this car as well, very nice light steering wheel. I think I always find these cars fascinating to drive when they have such a light steering wheel, because on our kind of roads in our city, in our country, with all the kind of turns we have and avoiding people and avoiding animals and avoiding bikes that keep coming in your way, a nice light steering wheel adds to the whole driving experience. You don't reach your destination tired. Yeah, this car is nice, easy to drive. You can tell the difference immediately between the diesel and the petrol. Quiet engine, a lot calmer. The Audis, not like the BMW. The BMW is like a young kid. It just wants to fight all the time. Wants to get up and run. You can tell with the kind of torque that comes in the BMW engines that they're waiting to go. They just want to be driven fast. This one feels like a cruiser. Very calm, chilled out, easy driving. We will put the top down. I don't want to put the top down right now. I want to finish talking about the car first, because I don't know how much you're going to be able to hear me once the top is down with all the breeze. I think this car is a good buy if you're going to use it for the top. Otherwise, buy the regular A3 because it's bigger. The four-door version, the two-door convertible. If you're going to use this car for the top, then it's a very, very good buy. Okay, let's try putting this in sport. Let's try using the paddles. So we're on M1. We'll see how responsive it is in this car. Okay. There is a bit of lag. Not anything too bad. There is a slight lag in the shifts. Of course, not like the BMW. The BMW is super quick. This one, you do have to wait a bit before it shifts. Nothing bad about it. If I didn't drive the BMW before this, I probably wouldn't have even realized this. M2, M1. Okay, the downshifts are pretty good. Okay, let's try putting this roof down and see what that's like. So,
get out the road, I told you. A car's coming, I stop you. You know I always got you. You know I always got you. Push it to the side, even if it means I die. I wouldn't hesitate about it, wouldn't even think.
Obviously, first thing, so much more light. You don't need the AC. You feel a little bit like everyone's looking at you, everyone's watching you, and you feel like they're with you in the car, especially when you're passing people and everyone starts looking at you. It kind of takes away your privacy, but I mean, great fun to drive. Beautiful day, the sun is out, it's not too hot, the temperature is about 26, 27 degrees, a good area with a lot of trees. So the engine, you can actually hear how sporty the engine is. With the top up, the cabin was really quiet, surprisingly, because it's a soft top. But the cabin was really quiet, you couldn't really hear the engine. But now you can hear the sportiness of the engine. It sounds so good.
Yeah.
I think also because I'm driving a petrol car for so long, and hearing a petrol engine after so long, just sounds so good. Sometimes you have to get into a petrol car and just drive it around. I love this car without the roof.
Finally can stand, back then still looking for trying land. Jump on my back, I'll take you home.
This building is like a BMW showroom. Two or three BMWs there, and of course my car, but that's gonna be leaving when I leave. But another X1 with the M kit on it, another 5 series here, another 5 series there. There's so many BMWs in this one building. Hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. This wasn't a car review. I haven't given you guys any information really, or technical information about these cars. Just wanted to show you what we have here with in the family, with my brother-in-law and his car collection. Got some pretty nice cars. He has a few more coming soon. I'll show you guys once he gets those. But until then, make sure to like, share, subscribe to my channel. Hope you guys like my content. If there's something that you guys want me to do, something different, you guys can put in the comments to keep you guys busy during these difficult times that we've got during lockdown. I know everyone's stuck. Hope you guys are being safe, helping people in any way you can.